Our confidence in trigonometry won't boost up until we know we can easily determine the value of any angle. In this video, we are going to learn how to very easily simplify and determine the value of trigonometric ratios of angles which involve either addition to or subtraction from 90 degree, 180 degree, 270 degree and 360 degree and are expressed as sine, cos, tan, cot, sec and cosec of 90 minus theta, 90 plus theta, 180 minus theta, 180 plus theta, 270 minus theta, 270 plus theta, 360 minus theta, and 360. Let's not forget that theta is an acute angle. Now, moving on to our content, let's draw x-axis and y-axis like so to represent the four quadrants, first, second, third, and fourth. Now, we are going to have to remember the word cos, the first letter of which represents cos. The second letter represents all, the third letter represents sine, and the fourth letter represents tan. We'll start with the fourth quadrant and write C here, and then move all the way in anti-clockwise direction and write A in the first quadrant, S in second, and T in third. We have written C in fourth quadrant means cos and its inverse sec ratio is positive here. A in first quadrant means all ratios are positive here. S in second quadrant means sine ratio and its inverse cosec ratio is positive here. Similarly, T in third quadrant means tan and its inverse cot ratio is positive here. Let's now write the angles which will fall in the quadrant of the chart. As we do this, we know that theta is an acute angle. And we know that x-axis here represents 0 degrees. The y-axis here represents 90 degrees. The x-axis here represents 180 degrees and the y-axis here represents 270 degrees. And this 0 degree also happens to be 360 degrees. Therefore, the angles 360 plus theta and 90 minus theta falls in the first quadrant here. We'll be finding out the value of all six trigonometric ratios for these angles. The angles 90 plus theta and 180 minus theta will lie in second quadrant here. We'll again be finding out the value of all trigonometric ratios of these angles. The angles 180 plus theta and 270 minus theta will lie in third quadrant here, and the angles 270 plus theta and 360 minus theta will lie in the fourth quadrant, and we'll be finding out the values of all the trigonometric ratios for all these angles. To be able to do all these difficult looking angles requires only two things to be kept in mind. One is the concept of cofunction in trigonometry. Sine is the cofunction of cos, as is cos the cofunction of sine. Tan is the cofunction of cot, as is cot that of tan. And sec is the cofunction of cosec, as is cosec that of sec. And another thing is the angle 90 degrees and 270 degrees. Whenever we are dealing with 90 degrees and 270 degrees, the function changes to its cofunction. The sine doesn't change when we are dealing with 180 degrees and 360 degrees. Let's now move on to solution. Let's give sine 90 plus theta a try. Since it has a 90 degrees, as we said, the function will change to its cofunction cos. And since it's in second quadrant where sine is positive, it will be plus cos theta. Practically, it can also be used to simplify expressions as sine 120, which we can write as sine 90 plus 30 equals to cos 30 equals to root 3 by 2. Similarly, let's see for cos 90 plus theta. It also has a 90 degree in it. Therefore, the function will change to its cofunction sine. And since it's in second quadrant where cos is negative, it will give rise to a minus, making it minus sine theta. The same applies to tan theta. It will change to cot owing to the fact that it also involves a 90 degrees in it, and since tan is also negative in this quadrant, it will be minus cot theta. It's clear now that the function will change to its cofunction for all the ratios, and only sine 90 plus theta and cosec 90 plus theta will be positive. All others will be negative. Moving on to the 180 minus theta angle, we know that when 180 degrees is involved, the function doesn't change to cofunction. So, all the functions will be as they are, like so, and only sine and cosec input will be positive in this quadrant. All remaining ones will be negative, giving the following results. Let's look at the case of 180 plus theta. Two things to observe is, There is 180 degrees involved and it's in third quadrant where only tan and cot are positive. Because of involvement of 180 degrees, all the functions will remain as they are and tan and cot will be positive, leaving all others negative. Therefore, the results will be as shown. With these two things, that is, looking at the angle involved and determining the quadrant in which the angle lies, we can simplify the expression and arrive at the solution of any trigonometric functions. Let's now say at random, say sec 360 minus theta. As we said, the first thing we are going to have to look at is 360. At 180 and 360, function doesn't change. So it will be sec as it is. And since it lies in fourth quadrant where cos and sec are positive, it will be positive, resulting in plus sec theta, which is equal to sec theta. Practically, it would help solve something like sec 330. Sec 330 would mean sec 360 minus 30 equals to sec 30 equals to 2 by root 3. Please note that this sec 330 can also be written in a number of ways, all of which will yield same results. One such way of writing sec 330 can also be sec 270 plus 60. Because of 270, the sign will change to cosec. Therefore, it will be cosec 60 equals to 2 by root 3. Hope this simple rule helped you some way or the other. Like and subscribe to our channel for further educational and insightful videos.